Have you ever felt like this before a performance or when you even think about performing in front of a crowd? If you do, well, you're not alone. Between 17 and 60% of musicians, it depends upon the study you read, experience stage fright, what's also known as performance anxiety. That's the fancy word. Hi, I'm Crystal from Peak Music and MySingingCoach.com. And in this video, I'm going to talk about some of the symptoms of performance anxiety so you can find out what's going on with you so you can address it. And if you stick around to the end, I have got a great tip on how to deal with it. So think about the last time that you experienced performance anxiety. All right, what was your experience? How did it feel to you? Just take a minute and make a comment. And I think what we're going to find is that many people experience the same symptoms, so we're all in the same boat. But at the same time, no two people experience performance anxiety in the exact same way. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to break it down for you in terms of four categories of symptoms of performance anxiety. And think about, as I'm talking, what you experience and how you identify with this. So the first group are emotional symptoms. Emotional symptoms include fear, dread, or worry about the judgment that others may have of you, of being harshly judged, for example. Yeah, I think you get the picture. The next category is behavioral. You know, when some people get fearful, when they are dreading something, they have a tendency to want to curl up in a ball. And as singers, we know that our posture is really important in good singing. And so we really do not want to be hunched over in a protective pose while we're singing. Another way that behavioral symptoms can occur is technique. So for example, we are not able to hit those high notes or do that run just like we did in the studio. Another cluster of symptoms, the third one, is cognition. And cognition is the $5 word for what we think and how we see the world. And so this is a big one for people. So their thoughts can often lead to behavioral and physiological symptoms. So, for example, my biggest problem is that I'm afraid that I'm going to forget the words. And so if there's a tricky part of a song and I know that I've forgotten the words there before and I come up on it and I'm singing and what's going through my head is, don't forget, don't forget, don't forget. And I think we all know if you say, don't forget, don't forget, don't forget, it's going to be higher likelihood that you're going to forget. You know, and other thoughts too, perfectionism. You know, I got to be perfect. Well, news for you, no one's perfect. And in fact, when you make that first small mistake in your performance, be thankful because then you're free. Welcome that first mistake. Another cluster of thoughts that people have is that we're not good enough, that we don't deserve to be there. Well, I got some more news for you. You are good enough and you deserve to be there. But it doesn't matter if I'm saying it, you have to believe it. Even though it is true that you are good enough, it doesn't feel like it to many people. And that, again, can lead to those other symptoms. So there's also physiological symptoms. And those include things like sweating, heart pounding, clammy hands, and the worst for singers, dry mouth. So this part of performance anxiety is a result of the part of our nervous system that gets all jacked up so we can either run away or kick some butt. But I'm telling you, in modern society, that fight or flight reaction really isn't very helpful in most situations. So that's what is happening to us. We have that fearful response and we're getting jacked up, and that part of our body, all of those symptoms I talked about, are getting ready to fight or take off. And one thing you don't want to do, you don't want to fight the audience, and you don't want to run away from the audience. So this is something that you have to work on to be able to control those physiological symptoms. So I think that you get the message that so many of these symptoms are interrelated to one another. So for example, I start thinking that I'm not going to be good enough and that someone's going to judge me harshly. Then that leads to the emotional reaction of fear. Then I have poor posture. I'm not able to hit the high notes. I make some mistakes. I've got some perfectionist thoughts going on. And my body starts to react, which is not good for my singing. And so it can be into a vicious cycle, right? So the next time I go to sing, I remember that time I screwed up, quote unquote, and then that just makes it even worse. It validates my fears to a certain extent. So, like I said, I'm going to give you a bonus tip, and it's on forgetting and trying to learning how to remember lyrics. I told you that that was one of my big issues. But before I get into that, shameless plug, do me a big favor and like us on Facebook and press that subscribe button on YouTube if that's where you're watching. I promise, good content's on its way. So the bonus tip is, if you do have that issue of forgetting, don't memorize a song from beginning to end. You gotta chunk it up. And what I mean by that, if it's a long verse, you might want to take it in two or three sections, or a chorus in one section, the bridge in one section. It just depends on how you want to chunk it up. And then learn it in chunks so that you could pull out a chunk and be able to sing that. So that if you forget something somewhere, well, you've got the next chunk ready to go. And what's really going to solidify it in your memory is working backwards. So if you can sing those chunks going backwards to forwards, you really have it in your memory. I use the chunking method a lot, and it really has helped me not only in singing, but also in my bass playing. So if I get off a little bit, I know exactly where to pick it up. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching. And also, next week, we're going to talk about what you can do to deal with some of these performance anxiety symptoms. So in between, just think about what it is that you experience, and then we'll talk about how to deal with it. All right, thanks again, and I'm Crystal from Peak Music Studios and MySingingCoach.com. Check us out.